This is the time of your life. This is what you've trained for your whole life. The great thing about the 200IM is that we've got all four strokes involved. We've got butterfly, backstroke, breaststroke, and finishing off with freestyle. In the pool, in the gym, these guys are smashing it every single day. This is the number one thing that I keep telling my swimmers at Wellington: streamline. Hi everyone, my name is James Goddard. I'm a former Olympic swimmer for Great Britain. I represented them at three Olympic Games: Athens 2004, Beijing 2008, and I had a home Olympic Games, London 2012. I'm now the director of swimming at Wellington College, Bangkok. Today, we're gonna have a little bit of fun. We're gonna have a look back at one of my races in London, the 200 meters individual medley. We've got some superstar swimmers in there. The great thing about the 200IM is that we've got all four strokes involved. We've got butterfly, backstroke, breaststroke, and finishing off with freestyle. We're gonna have a look over the race, analyze the race, and have some fun. Okay, let's get to the video. So already we can see here the start list. What a start list it is. Some big names, the biggest name ever in swimming. Michael Phelps in lane number three, Ryan Lochte in lane number four. We can see here me coming out of the call room. Fantastic moment. Look at all the team, the Great Britain flags here for Team GB. Got my Great Britain t-shirt on and Great Britain hat on as well. Fantastic moment, so lucky to have a home Olympic Games as well in London. We'll see the greatest swimmer of all time coming out in a second, Michael Phelps. Here he is from the United States of America. Likes to wear these big parka coats as well. It's to keep warm. They wear these big coats with these hoods on here to keep warm. I didn't really like to wear them because I got a little bit too hot. But Michael Phelps always wore these big coats called parka coats. With his headphones in, he likes to listen to the music. I was a music listener as well. Kind of gets you in the mood. It kind of like keeps you focused. Ryan Lochte, maybe the second greatest swimmer of all time behind Michael Phelps. Laszlo Cseh, big guy, big powerful Hungarian swimmer, really strong butterfly swimmer. He's an Olympic medalist in butterfly. Right behind the block here, the last point before we dive into the pool. You can see me at the top of the screen, the blue hat there. I'm kind of shaking my arms out here. You'll see a lot of swimmers shaking their arms, hands on hips, maybe playing with making sure their goggles and hat are ready. Just trying to stay relaxed. Very, very important to stay relaxed. You don't want to get kind of tense here. You don't want to overthink things either. You're trying to stay relaxed, remember what you've done in training, and get ready to dive in the pool, because this is the time of your life. This is what you've trained for your whole life. Super flexible arms. Look how flexible he is. Very important as well. Flexibility, mobilization. That's something that me and the Wellington team are we work really, really hard on our flexibility. Okay, off the start. Again, this is the number one thing that I keep telling my swimmers at Wellington: streamline, 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 streamline. On every single time you push off the wall or dive in, it has to be in a streamline. And not just a normal streamline, a perfect streamline, okay? We can see here, perfect streamline from Ryan Lochte here, from his hand, from his fingertips, all the way to his toe. You can see that body position, perfect straight line. This is a perfect streamline. We have to do this off every single wall, because actually, guys, this is the fastest way to move through the water, okay? A lot of people think it's freestyle on top of the water. Swimming front crawl like this is the fastest stroke, but it's not the fastest way to travel through the water. The fastest way is underwater in a perfect streamline like this, butterfly leg kicks, and Ryan Lochte is the best ever to do this. 15 meters underwater into our butterfly. Down this first 50 meters, guys, you want to stay nice and relaxed on your butterfly, right? We don't want to force that stroke too much, okay? You almost want to float down the pool. Keep those arms really relaxed because we've got three more lengths. You want to stay nice and relaxed in your stroke. Don't overkick your legs. Everything needs to be nice and relaxed, almost like you're floating down that pool. It looks like he'll touch in front of coming up to the top, at the top of the screen, you can see him in the blue hat. Onto the backstroke, we can see here, again, great streamline underwater, all right? On your front, on your back, no different. One hand on top of the other, squeezing behind your ears. You can see Michael Phelps squeezing behind that ears. You need a good butterfly leg kick under the water. Into the backstroke, almost three or four boys in a line. You can see Michael Phelps just in front here. Pereira's got a nice backstroke here in the white hat. Backstroke, my favourite stroke. I found it a lot easier than the other strokes. Some very important parts of backstroke: keeping that head nice and still. All right, we've got to keep that head nice and still. If we move the head around too much, it can really affect the balance in the stroke. All right. A lot of swimmers, when they don't, if they have their head to one side, or if they move their head too much, they'll end up snaking down the pool too much. We've got to keep that head nice and still for that balance in the stroke. Another big part of the stroke is the rotation. We have to rotate our shoulders while keeping our head still. Very tricky to keep that head still and rotate at the same time, but we rotate our shoulders for power, okay? For balance as well, but mainly for power. If you think about when I talk to my Wellington swimmers, a good example that I like to use is throwing a ball. Okay, if we throw a ball, we don't stand flat like this and throw a ball. We rotate our shoulders to get the most power. Same in backstroke, we rotate our shoulders to generate that power in the stroke.
He's already got too many.
See Michael Phelps, actually at the 100 meters, Michael Phelps is just ahead of the world record line. Yeah, so he's on for a great swim. I'm at the top of the screen, I've got an okay backstroke. You can see I'm maybe fifth at this moment here. Backstroke to breaststroke turn, very tricky. A lot of the guys do a flip turn. Very hard for me to explain, I need to show it. So maybe we can maybe do a video where I show you how to do a backstroke to breaststroke turn. But breaststroke, okay, so breaststroke is the slowest of the four strokes, all right? Why is it the slowest? It's the slowest because, very simple answer, it causes the most drag and resistance, okay? So if we think about front crawl being the fastest stroke, everything with front crawl, nothing sticks out from your shoulders. Everything is kind of in this space in here. With breaststroke, everything is sticking out and everything is going up and down. Okay, so in breaststroke, when we breathe, we pull our arms out and we come up to breathe like this. When we come up to breathe, all the water is hitting our chest here, causing loads of drag and resistance. When we pull out here, everything is sticking out, causing drag and resistance. When we kick out, causing drag and resistance. That is why breaststroke is the slowest stroke.
What has he got left? He's already had a heavy workout.
Some great shots of these guys here. Talked about Michael Phelps having great four strokes. Look at his breaststroke. He's actually pulling away from the rest of the field on his breaststroke. And it's probably his weakest stroke. Breaststroke is probably Michael Phelps' weakest stroke. And you can see he's holding that lead. If anything, he's pulling away from the rest of the guys. Two-handed touch on the turn. When we do a turn, it's not a great point to pause it there. But when we do a turn, guys, whenever we do a turn on any stroke, we want to try and make ourselves a nice tight ball. If I just pause the video really quick there while I explain this. We want to make ourselves a nice tight ball when we turn, okay? See a lot of swimmers making the mistake of when they touch the wall, like for instance on breaststroke, they lift themselves up like this, they come round the side, it's too slow. All right, we want to make ourselves a nice tight ball so we can get round that wall nice and quick. We've gone to the freestyle leg here. Michael Phelps, Olympic champion on freestyle. So if any of these guys want to beat Michael Phelps, it's going to be really, really tough right now. Something that I want you guys to see is the leg kick. Look at the leg kick here. These guys have done nearly 200 meters and their legs are going absolutely crazy, okay? Massive, massive leg kicks. Put kick sets in your training session. Very important to put kick sets in your training sessions. And we can see the finish here. Michael Phelps finished on a nice long stroke in here. What a race, what a swimmer. So as you can see, guys, here, a huge smile on Michael Phelps' face. All that hard work in the gym and in the pool has come to fruition. He's won the Olympic gold medal, and what a swim from Michael Phelps. Today, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you got something valuable out of it. The concepts that we talked about is something that was very important to me during my swimming career, and it's something that we are doing right now at Wellington School. The facilities are amazing. The program is from Learn to Swim all the way to competitive swimming. If you want to know more information, please do get in touch.